point it needs to be corrected, but it, my sense, when I watch the school board or the planning board, I mean, you might not quite begin to hear someone, but after a while, they get it adjusted. It's not great, but I mean, it's passable. We, I don't know, my thought is that we might want to revisit it depending on the nature of the cuts that we have.
I'd go along with that.
I'll go along with that, too.
Yeah, I would, too, because we have been each year investing quite a bit of money in capital outlay for cable TV, I mean, in getting the number of cameras we need, et cetera. And this is the first year that we've really had nothing major.
I don't think I asked for anything.
Though there was nothing last year?
No.
Okay. Well, you know, it's not an overwhelming amount of money. Are we talking about, what, $77 million?
We're talking about $77 million.
The other thing, if the franchise renewal is up this year, we might make it a condition of the franchise renewal is that they upgrade the sound system for us. Make the cable company pay for it.
But didn't you also have something else that you wanted to ask them to do?
Yes.
I mean, can they?
I'd like to have a studio and whatever over the school department at the high school, too. Why not ask for both? They're making people know.
If you don't answer, you'll never know.
That's right. I just want to make sure you haven't forgotten about that one.
He wasn't substituting one for the other, I understand.
That's what you're talking about?
Yes.
I understand your concern.
No, what I'd, ideally, what I'd like to have is another access station for the school department and a fully equipped for them over at high school. They could do live things out of the gym and out of the auditorium.
I think that would be super, too. I think it would be great.
Any other questions on the cable TV account? Bill?
I'd just like to ask Lillian, how is it working today with all these different mics around here? Good
really,
or bad?
No, it's actually it's pretty good.
I asked my wife when I went home, and she said it was real good. And I was wondering whether these extra mics, I don't know what it was, but she'll start a council meeting or something like that, and she can't hear somebody, and bang, goes to something else.
That's her excuse anyway,
yeah, right.
For turning the channel, Bill. I'm not sure we can.
Anything more disgusting with her, I can't understand what people say. Yeah.
Well, Billy, we do compete with Jeopardy.
I know she likes to watch Jeopardy.
Lillian, I want to thank you very much for your preparation on the budget, and thank you for your time and service in this position.
You have done
a very good job.
Thanks.
You'll be
great.
Missed and hard to replace.
But I'm still here.
Yes.
Thank you.
We'll say goodbye at the appropriate time. You might change your mind, you know. You're going to think that direction.
We've cut 8380 up.
We are already coming down to 7780. So we've already saved $600 on that. By the, well, that's good.
Maybe we could sell
those
some
ads. Those are the savings we'd like to find, John.
Yes.
All right.
We are. Moving on to page 149.
Let the channel do a commercial every once in a while.
149.
Let me find it. It's the first green tab. Human services, general assistance.
Yeah, you get the general assistance sheet first.
Yeah, let's do general assistance since it's first on there. Yeah. 420.
It's proposed to budget $20,000 for general assistance. It's higher, it's lower than the cost for the last 2 years, but we had one case that had been somewhat expensive that was recently resolved, so we've seen a decline in our cost.
Good. Any concerns, questions on that?
Plus, the new law that was passed in December is making a difference.
Yeah, I'm sure it is. Are we seeing a decrease?
I've handled a couple of cases myself and been amazed the way, you know, how it's changed under the old system where it would have been like $400 a month. It would have helped them. It's $200 and something. Mm-hmm. It's, you know, how it's going to work in the long run for those that are in need. I'm sure the legislature will be looking at it closely.
Yeah, I've heard that's a similar experience elsewhere. Okay, on to human services.
It might be just as easy on the Human Services to look at your side sheet on page 19. These are all the different agency fundings. As you can see, there are four accounts with a difference. First, Community Health Services. They provide home health care to many people in the community, particularly after they've gotten out of the hospital. They have a hospice program as well, and I think it's a very important service to a lot of the elderly in our community. That's $17,325, an increase of 5% over last year. Community Counseling Center, $3,300, the same. Dental Fund, if some, particularly kids in the community, run into some dental emergency and the parents don't have any money to deal with it, we have a fund of $500 that goes toward helping out with those problems. We deal primarily with the social workers at the schools to utilize that account. The Center for Therapeutic Recreation, or the old Leisure Center for the Handicapped, provides services for a number of individual residents of Cape Elizabeth. I think I've crossed off all their names. I did, but you can see two adults and two children. They do use our pool somewhat, but not to the extent that we thought they might have last year. So that is one of the major increases in the budget, but if you look at Human Services overall, it's not that large an increase, but that's an increase of almost doubling, up to more than doubling, up to $3,168. Ingraham Volunteers, a small increase up to $982. The Senior Citizen Transportation Program is the same, Southern Maine at $3,000, Southern Maine Area Agency on Aging, $3,300. Holy Innocence Homemaker Service, $4,950. Prop, $1,505. Regional Transportation Program, $1,160. Planned Parenthood of Northern New England, $479. Family Crisis Center, $1,000. All those ones I just mentioned are no change. Day One, one of our tenants down the fort, $325, an increase of $17, and Hospice of Maine, no change.
Do we have any discussion concerns on this list?
Michael, last year and during the year, we've had discussions about duplicating contributions from the county,
yep,
and from the town. And since we're making contributions through the county, through our, whatever we want to call it.
County assessment.
The assessment. Are any of these in that duplication category?
A good many of them also receive assistance from the county. You know, unfortunately, the way that the Human Services system was set up in the county, and particularly it was the state that set it, is the state will give you so much grant through the Bureau of Mental Health, Bureau of Mental Retardation. They'll give you so much from different human service areas, but it's contingent upon you matching so much locally. So what's happened is all these agencies are forced to go grovel here and there, you know, between the county and private groups and towns. A lot of the towns, you know, would spend the whole afternoon hearing from these different agencies. You haven't required that, but you know, unfortunately, that's the way the system is. And
I just wanted to know if that what was continuing.
Yeah, it is.
We decided we did not need to have them come into this session with us.
Now they could probably get some of these funds sooner here than they could through the county. Mm.
We have very few strings, you know, attached to it, and what we usually do is after July they'll send a letter indicating they want their money. We'll usually send it, and then around December 1st we look who hasn't asked yet, and we send the rest of it.
What's child dental emergency?
That's the one I mentioned for the needy kids that the school social worker recommends to us, that some kid has some dental problem there. Parents don't have any money.
The total amount requested is basically $42,000.
I don't have any specific concerns. I think there is a duplication, and there was a great debate last year that reached an enormous public forum with many of the individuals from the human services agencies coming to represent their particular agencies. There was a cut overall. There was a proposal to cut it entirely, which would have been about it would have been almost, the entire amount Cape Elizabeth budget each year for the county, and it didn't wash. I mean, everyone felt, I think, as a bottom line, that this economic climate simply wasn't the year to start making the cut. On the other hand, one of the things that does differ from the point of view of the different agencies that do come before the Cumberland County Board of Commissioners, as well as the budget members, there's a very, very lengthy and sophisticated application that each of the human services agencies have to fill out in order to get funding from the county. It's a very extensive form. You're very clear about how much is overhead and how much is directly going to the individual person in need. So I can only say that as long as there is a quote-unquote double-dipping phenomenon going on, and that we're sponsoring the $42,000 here, and we're also sponsoring it again at the tune of 5% with our overall contribution to the county, at least what is happening right now, I think, is as a sophisticated process as you can have. And Michael has served on the Human Resources Board for the county for a couple of years. So it's a policy issue. As long as they give the money, at least they're, I think, evaluating the requests in the right way.
At the
county level, yeah.
Any other comments, concerns with any individual item here?
No, just a comment on the overall human services budget for this town. Probably close to $42,000 is only 1% of our total budget. So that's pretty small.
Yes, it is.
In the larger cities in the country, they're spending 50-60% of the budget.
Especially if you have a public hospital. Mm-hmm. I mean, it just murders you.
Okay. Put that one to rest. Go on to Town Hall. 610, the second white tail, page 185.
Custodial services will continue to be provided by the school department. Power is budgeted at 7,100. We have seen some increase here in this building, but not to the extent of the public safety building. Water and sewer, 2,050, again affected by both the town's sewer increase and the water district's water increase. Building repair, all the miscellaneous repairs we do during the year, $3,200. That also, we do purchase a painting every year at the art show for $300 out of that amount, the Indian Art Show, most of which have gone over to the community center. We need to start replenishing our supply here. But it's a nice thing to do, and it really does improve things here, along with Dudley Bostwick's loan paintings, which there are two new ones this week. Heat, again, will be reduced, $7,700. Currently.
No, it won't be reduced by 77.
No,
be careful.
No.
It shows that 7,700 will be up for reduction.
Cleaning supplies, 320, and no outlay proposed.
Okay. Any questions for the town hall?
The community center, there's a telephone over there, $340. We got a call yesterday or Thursday from the senior citizens over there. How do you turn on the disposal? So, you know, it's good to have a phone over there, not only for emergencies, but also for, you never know what issue, question you're going to be asked. The power over there, $700. Sewers, this is just water, $240. Building maintenance, $2,500. The outside of it was not stained at all, and those natural buildings like that do need to be stained, so there is money here for that. It is something that I'm going to talk with Bob about to see if maybe the summer crew could do it at some point. There's nothing that's too high or too dangerous. So. But there are a number of things on the outside there that do need to be done, that like to make sure it's in good condition.
Does it have to be done this year?
If you look at it closely, it's starting to, what do you call it, when it kind of like bakes and you get all the little, it begins to flake. The blistering. The heat is $1,000 for that structure. Cleaning supplies, $150. That's the budget.
Any other questions on $12.26?
Probably the heating will be reduced by the change in the cost of fuel.
I'm not so sure I will that one, because I'm so unsure with the heat.
Because it hasn't been open long enough to really get a track record for it.
Building repair on the rental units. This is for the two brick buildings down at Fort Williams that are leased out. One of them is now rented to Day One. I'm having discussions with the other one, with a party that wants to pay very, very little rent, but that would go in the building and maintain, would take care of it, keep it heated, and pay for all the utilities. It's someone interested, a group of three women who would like to have artist studios in there and have a little gallery downstairs. It's a very preliminary discussion at this point. Unfortunately, we just haven't been able to find a tenant for it, and we're paying the heat for it, and there's all sorts of additional problems with it, and handicapped accessibility that would have to be dealt with, and there's problems with using the upstairs fire codes, and there's a real problem in trying to, when it's limited to simply nonprofit, cultural, educational, those types of agencies.
Those are limited in 400.
Within the council policy. So I've got, last year was budgeted $2,000, I've got $6,000 in there. We also did open the bids for the handicapped ramp. It was, the bids came in at our original estimate, not what the cut was. I don't remember that discussion at the council meeting. The bid came in at $14,000, and we also had the architect's fees in addition to that. So we're now trying to whittle that cost down. The architect working with the low bidder. We received three bids on it, none of whom probably were at all aware of the discussion that comes to me.
Any questions on the Fort Williams things? Spurwink Church?
$2,100 part-time payroll. This pays for the greeter stipend for going over opening and closing the church. Also, we pay an individual to do a little bit of cleaning several times a year inside there. Telephone, $500. This not only funds the telephone, but also the alarm that is there. Power, $375. Water, $140. Building repair, $1,000. Heat, $350. That's it.
Any questions? Phyllis?
On building repair, do we have some money set aside for painting the building?
Yes, you do.
Has that?
That's going to be done this year.
It has?
During the season. Will okay. be done this season.
I know we had a lot of talks last year about maintenance and prioritizing the things that need to be done. And why would the power be so great when this building's only open part of the year?
Because the sprinkler system down in the little control room, there's an electric heater down there
so that it
won't freeze. You have to have the sprinkler, where the sprinkler control comes into the building.
Yeah.
You have to have a little bit of
a drafty spot, probably.
Excuse me?
It's in that church.
It's probably drafty and.
Yeah, it's in the little concrete room that was constructed that down in the basement is really.
$6,000 is a lot of money.
$6,000?
What are you saying?
This
Phil?
Power. Oh, no. Excuse me. I flipped the page too.
Oh, jeez.
Okay.
$375.
Oh, okay.
$375.
Now I understand why you were so distressed.
Yes. Okay.
Feel better?
Yes.
Good. Anything else in the Spurwink Church? Okay, thank you. Intergovernmental assessments, 710. Second blue tab, page 209.
The county government assessment is down slightly. This isn't in the general fund, but it is shown here for reference. The transit district, we were a member of that until 1978, when Councilor Jordan and others decided to pull out of it. We were responsible for all the buses they bought during the period we were in it. The debt and that is finally, as you can see, about to run out. We just have three more years payments, including this current year. The sewer fund contribution from the general fund for all of the infiltration that goes into the system as well as for the general improvement to the environment as without having a sewer system, $80,000, no change from last year. Council of Governments, that includes $15,000 for both dues as well as for the different joint service fees for the bidding that goes on. We pay for that all out of one account. Maine Municipal Association dues, $7,910. Very embarrassing if you were that. That's it for intergovernmental exceptions.
It was also very surprising when I received the bill at home for the dues.
I spoke to him about that.
I remember that. Yes, I did.
Maybe they figured they knew where the bucks were and they weren't in the town, but they was at your house.
Not at that house.
Not for that bill, for sure.
That's for
Michael
sure.
Or Jan, did we get a figure from COG this year as to what we saved by participating in joint services?
Yeah.
If we did, I don't remember.
We didn't.
I know they did not increase their dues amount. They generally do something.
I know in other years we have received it, it usually shows that we at least break even, if not do a lot better.
Yeah. Would you make it up to ask them?
They usually let you know that at the General Assembly
yeah.
meeting, which is usually in May.
They may be coming up.
We've encouraged them to have I don't know if you've heard anything more on that. Someone spoke to me about why doesn't COG have an annual get-together anymore so all the regional officials can commiserate on the issues that they're dealing with. And I haven't heard anything.
I haven't heard anything. We'll have what's this? We had our March meeting. We dealt with police issues. But I
still interested in that. I'll speak to John about that as well.
Okay.
What do you want to?
It's fine for you to. Okay. One less than my last.
Janet's the, for those, just the representative on content.
Okay. Any other comments on intergovernmental assessments? Amazing how we make time just, up in the afternoon.
Just one thing. I'd like to, again, commend the county commissioners for, I know Wayne was on the Budget Advisory Committee and Billy had been, but I think they really did an outstanding job of balancing a whole lot of demands out there with concern that the municipalities were expressing for the taxes.
It's nice to have that group be so responsive.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we always felt like they were being responsive, so that's always appreciated. Okay, we need to do miscellaneous. Miscellaneous public protection. Going back to 240, which we did not do this morning.
Okay. 106.
Thank you. Page 106.
No. 105.
That's 105, and we're looking at account 240.
Okay. Streetlights, you can see on page 108, now that you switch to 105, our monthly streetlight bill. Currently, before the most recent 8% increase, was $5,431 a month. It subsequently passed an additional increase of 8%, bringing it up to about $5,900 monthly. We also pay out of this account for sprinklers. I've spent a lot of time earlier this spring and winter with Chief Pickering overlooking streetlights and streetlight issues. He has identified in a report you have in your stack there potential savings of $9,000 that could be made from eliminating quite a few streetlights this year and $19,000 that could be eliminated in that could be saved next year. The problem is when you the year you eliminate them, if there's any useful life charges in them, you have to assume them. Streetlights were last reduced around 1982, and it was extremely controversial.
And many were added back in.
And some were added back in. But, you know, we're extremely concerned that the cost, you know, is going from $59,000 to $71,000. And we spent a lot of time looking at potential criteria. I think the chief did an outstanding job on it. And it really comes down to a policy decision. Are you happy with the number of streetlights we have? Or would you like to implement the new policy as outlined by the chief of police?
So what we have proposed in the budget is the existing situation, existing
That's
street
right.
lights. what is proposed would give us a first-year savings of fiscal year 93 of $8,000 less than that. We're down to 63,000. And then thereafter, a savings of $20,000 annually is predicted. I'd like to hear Counselor's thoughts on...
You want my thoughts?
Absolutely.
I think that, yes, you can go ahead and reduce some street lighting, and as long as you don't get into the reduced safety factors, when you ride around the town and most of the lights have intersections and curves and what have you. But they're going to get their buck somewheres, and if everybody goes and reduce their street lighting in the town, then the rates going up to the rest of the people. So they're going to come out with a budget that of their needs to run them and have some money for the investors. That's the way I look at it.
You're anticipating the residential rates would be increased?
I think they would.
Lessening a demand on...
I ain't going to say they're going to the gate and turn one out and somebody else is going to increase, but once it happens, they're going to come back for more. And I think there's going to be some work done here pretty soon, maybe after legislature gets done or by fall, that Central Maine's going to look at that whole issue, because a lot of homeowners, their power has gone up a lot. I don't know about your people, but mine went up $100 down there from a year ago, just like that. And I think there's some upset people out there, and they're going to do something about it. All they did was give the businesses a credit and put it on to the public homeowner.
And street lighting, too.
And street lighting, too. That's right.
We had the highest percentage increase in a single class of service. And, you know, with public safety, what they did was they changed it to a different class of service than it was.
I can't understand that with the other buildings in the town, why that one was different classifications. I just can't understand.
Do you think there's a potential when the PUC reviews the CMP rates that they would reduce the increase for the streetlight sector?
No. Other because no one has really pushed the issue with them.
Do we want to take on that one?
No, I, that's why I haven't, because I no. we can only take
somebody
on so many
else's
issues
turn.
At one time.
Yeah. Any other thoughts on this, Jane?
I'm not sure that the savings that would be realized from adopting this policy would be worth the at least perceived lack of safety that some people would feel would result from their losing their lights. And I know there's a section here that would offer citizens who lost their street light to adopt the light.
That may be some, you know, ways to mm-hmm. donate to the town, adopt your local
street. Right, but then I think we get into a real policy issue of some people are going to have a street light and they don't have to pay for it. Others are going to have to adopt a street mm-hmm. light. And I think if I could see a greater realization of savings from doing this, I might be more interested. But I know how upset people were 10 years ago when we tried to reduce the number of streetlights, and how safe some people feel just having that light out there, particularly in the more remote neighborhoods, less built up, and particularly with where there are more elderly residents. Mm-hmm. So I think we ought to think pretty carefully before we go to this kind of reduction of services, which it really is.
That's what it would be. It's always hard to take away something that people have already. I found the study and the printout that we got very informative.
Yes.
I think we know where the safety, the strictly public safety type lights are for intersections and such, as Bill mentioned, because it's coded out that way. Found it very helpful to have this. Any other comments about this issue?
I tend to agree with Billy. I think, you know, that the whole issue, unfortunately, of the PUC and the regulation of public utilities, if you cut something out, you know, they're going to get you in the back door. I mean, they're just going to raise the rates. I think the same thing with water. The more conservative you are with trying to conserve water, then the water rates go up anyway. I mean, I think the public utility system build a a system whereby they have salaries and everything has to be compensated, and the maximum figure never seems to go down. They just figure a different way to divide it. So I think it's just penny-wise, pound-foolish. You'll lose in the end.
Okay, thank you. Anybody else? So we will leave the $71,000 as proposed. Okay, thank you.
Fire protection, $161,000 for hydrants.
How many? Do we have any hydrants there?
We have volumes of material.
I just wanted to know, right?
I don't know off the top of my head.
430, 171.
Oh, no, it's 257.
I don't know.
Curiosity question.
I'm pretty sure it's over 200, I know.
Now, could it be by the end of April?
April 27th.
That will allow us to reduce that potentially?
Let's hope so.
Is it a true statistic at this moment that Cape Elizabeth pays more for fire hydrants than South Portland?
Yes.
Absolutely true.
Yes.
I think that's crazy.
That's right. That's what we had that night. That's just...
Oh, overall, yeah.
Yeah.
We pay, currently we pay $118,000 and change. They pay around $80,000, $90,000.
And they have more hydrants than...
They have double the number of hydrants.
They have twice as many hydrants.
And half the cost.
Half of what we do.
Yeah, the factor of four. If you think about it.
Group discounts.
Miscellaneous public protection, the harbor master stipend, $1,700. No change, although that is in a separate account. I tried to get anything involved in payroll, I tried to get in the payroll account for it, as we did with cable TV and otherwise. Social Security, workers' comp are 130 and 163 respectively. The supplies for the sealer, that's for the printing of the little stickers and all those type things, $100. And harbor enforcement expense, $300. That's for belonging to the Maine Harbor Master Association and the different forms that Steve Jordan uses. Other things that comes to me that you please consider purchasing this.
That ends the account on miscellaneous public protection. Are there any other questions? Thank you. We have revenues and payroll issues. Let's do revenues. That's the beginning. First red tab, page 35.
We ready? Interest and late charge is $45,000. Sam Shapiro, the state treasurer, has required we reduce that from 12% to 10%.
How do we get that reinstated to 12%?
Well, that's, if I had more time, that would have been another issue that I would have spent some time on. A couple of people spoke to Sam, and it's based on the unsecured commercial loan rate that banks in Maine offer. And this is supposed to be set at whatever that highest rate is. Well, Sam checked with three banks. One of the bank managers said if he offered an unsecured commercial loan, it'd be the last loan he ever offered. So that was either Fleet or Key. And then, you know, one person said, 10%. But yet they don't give it. So it's based on a standard that just does not exist in the state. So Sam sets whatever rate he pleases. So, you know, I'm hoping to work with MMA to get the legislation changed so that it's a fair amount and that it be tied. Actually, what I'd like to see that it's tied to what the state charges for pass-through income taxes, which is 12%. You know, why the state charges 12%, they tell municipalities they only charge 10. I don't know. It's totally inconsistent.
That needs to be fixed.
Excise taxes, we're doing so far this year, we've now taken in $610,000. We were doing much better in that area. You can see there's a projected increase here of $70,000. Registration fees are up as the state has increased its fees. Right, we've collected almost $15,000 so far this year. Clerk's fees have been down a little bit, although we've done a little bit better in the last couple months, so we're up to $3,617 so far this year, but that's budgeted at $4,000. Police fines and fees, that includes the alarm monitoring fees, the bills that are about to be sent out. Overdue book fines, $4,000 income. Miscellaneous receipts, $23,524. The reason that's $524 is that's how I did a run of all the revenues and found we were within $524 of where we were last year. So In order to get it come out exactly even from last year overall revenues, I assume we'll somehow get $524 extra dollars. Investment income, a reduction from $156,000 down to $80,000. Right, because of lower interest rates. Classroom lease portables, $105,000. It's leased to the school department. Depending on what's happening 65 miles north today, we're either going to get $325,000 in revenue sharing funds or something less. They're looking for $20 million, and we're all praying that it doesn't come out of general purpose aid or state revenue sharing. Just don't know. But again, that is something that on November 6th, it was proposed to be totally eliminated.
That's right.
And a lot of people across the state worked together to make sure that some of it was there. And we met with the governor on Monday, and I asked him if he was going to propose reducing it next year. And he said something, come on, Mike, do you think I'm as dumb as I look? So he's apparently gotten the message that he ought not to take on that issue again, and he has no intention of reducing it in next year's budget. So that was certainly good news. He was in good humor on Monday. Miscellaneous state, the state reimburses us half of what we spent for general assistance, $10,000. We still expect to get the growth management funds. That's still in the budget as of, even though the program's been eliminated because we're already in the pipeline, we still expect to get $6,000. Miscellaneous is $2,000. That's odds and ends that we get from them. Unappropriated surplus, proposing to use none to help fund the budget, the same as last year. Spurwink Church, use fees, $3,600. You did raise the rates for out-of-town residents, but I'm assuming that that might discourage some use, so the revenue stays the same. Refuse disposal revenue, I really don't want to plan on any because, you know, we really don't know, you know, what the market's going to be at any given point. Right now, so far, we have made $582 this year on that. Local roads block grant, $62,000. That is, as I discussed, that could increase depending if the June bond issue passes. But again, if that would have to be directly spent anyway into road work during the next year. I haven't projected any income for Fort Williams Building 324. We don't have a tenant. I think it's unwise to plan on money there. This year, we are budgeting income for day one, $7,800. Cable franchise fee, $17,000. We could generate additional revenue, but that's an issue to be considered as you renew the franchise and consider that agreement. We get, to anyone watching, the town receives 3%. At the end of your bill, there's an add-on for the franchise fee, and that's 3% of your basic service charge, and it adds up to $17,000 income for the community. Boat excise tax is $17,000. Miscellaneous building permits, you can see the budget here, going from $25,000 up to $45,000. And again, that's as a result of simply building activity, picking up additions, people doing odds and ends at the houses. Subdivision inspection is included in the above account. Binocular revenue, those are the binoculars down to the fort, bring in a lot of quarters. Poor farm proceeds is now out of this budget because it should not be in the general fund. All those amounts very obviously have to go into the Thomas Jordan Trust. Library copier, we do now have a copier in the codes office. We're finding we have lots of people coming in wanting copies. We're now charging 20 cents a copy there, and that was paid for out of this library copier fund with the plan that it'll be reimbursed as well as it will be enough there to buy the new library copier when that time comes due. So that's been a
can we call that step. Something besides library copier fund to reflect?
Yeah, we will. We'll change it. Street openings, that's all that every time someone opens a street, they need to pay a fee. That's $1,300. Reserving of the picnic shelter, 2,400 different groups. This is the revenue here for the parking for like the symphony and for family fun day and such would go in here, $3,000. Police special payroll, you remember the $6,900 in police special assignments? This is the income that comes in on the other end that includes the benefits as well as the actual direct payroll. Mooring permits, $1,000. That's it for revenue.
Well, I thought you were leaving another one blank, so we could come up with new ones.
Why not?
Are there any questions to Mike about the revenues?
Again, totally flat from last year, although you can see there's wide variances in individual revenue areas.
We again assume you're being cautious. We know you are.
Hope so.
Served us well so far?
Yeah, so far this year we've taken in 81% of general fund revenues. We still need to collect $304,872 to make budget. So I do not anticipate any problem in doing that.
Sounding good. Okay. And
we have a recap on what we did.
Payroll issues.
Payroll issues. I think we discussed quite a bit of that this morning. Mm-hmm. I won't say anything on it unless anyone has questions.
I'm curious if people want to get back to anything on payroll issues. I mean, that was part of basically part of the morning discussion we had with the police chief. Maybe we'll get more done this morning.
I just want to say on page 4 that you've got miscellaneous there twice.
I blew it.
What's your concern, Mr. Director?
What caused that? I typed that one myself, so I assume full responsibility.
Excuse me.
What is it, Billy?
Miscellaneous down there, one's at the bottom, one's 3 up, 4 up. Not waiting on them, on the list of
$5.58?
Yes. Said twice.
Yes, it is.
I think the point there is, I think it's interesting and why that's there, is the $53, everyone gets all of the municipal services, all the things we've been talking about all day long, libraries and parks and roads and dumps, I keep joking saying that. Planning, the cost of tax collection, the school department, everything else. And I think it's a damn good bargain, particularly when you look at what some other things cost these days.
Any other comments? We can do a recap and make sure we're all in agreement with our revisit items and such. The items that I came up with as I listened, I don't know if somebody wants to put these down and tally them. Definite places of agreement were in for the copier that's already been purchased. That was in there, two separate accounts for $1,375 twice. So that's been taken out already. Okay. We took out $3,000 for the light bars. And we took out $1,200 an accounting error in one of the 230 accounts. Which one it was. 2009. And we took out $50,000 in the two roadway accounts.
You took $60,000 out of paving and you added $10,000 by combining the accounts. Same thing.
Right. You can buy this. We took out $3,000 in the town hall account for the printer will be purchased in the current fiscal year. We took out $1,500 from the council's account for the National League of Cities meeting. We're expecting about a $5,000 savings in all the fuel accounts, gasoline, diesel, and heating oil.
Okay. Employee benefit credit.
$22,000 credit for unemployee benefits. We at least revised the cable TV account by a reduction of $600 for an addition error. We're not going to revisit the rest of that. And a number of other things you wanted to verify. Does somebody have a... Did you total that for us?
No, I was totaling something else.
Okay.
Eric's going to keep in a pretty good total.
Did you take that 70 out of the cable TV, you took 600?
I took 600, even with what, if we left the sound system in there, it's 600 less than what it's shown at, because it was added up improperly.
Oh, it would be 380.
It was, that's the way it was added, if you re-added it, 7780.
I think we really ought to try to get it out of the cable company.
That's right.
We have that down to revisit, we're saving at least 600right there already without doing it.
Want to go over the other revisits?
That's roughly $89,000.
About $89,000. Okay, we also want to revisit under the police accounts, the 210s, the audio recording system, and looking at replacing two cruisers as opposed to one. We're coming back to the fire chief position.
Public works truck.
Public works truck. The ladder truck for the fire department. Is that it? That's all that I have. Does anybody have anything else on there? So we don't have a lot to revisit at this point.
Just one general, I know you're looking for no tax increase, but do you want me to, are you looking for me to come back with anything in particular?
No increase, yes.
But that's not realistic.
Anything's realistic.
Do you have ideas, Bill, on how we would choose?
Yeah, I think I got my idea too, but I would like to...
I think there are ideas that we need to start hearing about.
That's right. Well, we've got so many high costs, like the water and power, that we have no control over.
How much would we be looking for, in addition to what we've done today, to get to a no tax increase?
To get to what?
No tax.
No tax.
If you assume the $150,000 out of the school budget, which I don't know if that's a correct assumption, you're looking at another $500,000.
In addition to that?
Not out of the municipal budget.
Yeah.
$500,000 total, I wasn't saying.
He did not say municipal.
No, about $500,000.
Okay, but we're working on the municipal budget, so why shouldn't it be different?
We're talking about the total tax rate.
Yeah.
And that's what we would need. On the total tax rate, we'd need another $500,000 cut to get it to be a 0% tax rate increase. And if somebody has an idea of how to get us there, I think it's time to share that.
The other thing I think I heard today was, I didn't sense that you're going to spend $75,000 for a ladder truck in this budget plus $66,000. For a public works truck, and that while you may be willing to buy both, you want me to structure financing that would essentially eliminate $65,000 or $70,000, whatever the.
See, it makes quite a difference, Michael, as to what you're working for. We've got $89,000 of direct cuts that we've taken. Then if we put that $74,000 for your fire truck that you've got in this year's budget, that makes $163,000 already. Mm-hmm. That you've actually cut today by buying the dump truck if you go that way. So you can get this up near $200,000 worth of deductions if you leave the $74,000 in there with no problem at all.
So $163,000 is a long way from $200,000.
I know, we'll work on it.
Yeah. Okay. Maybe nervous there for a second.
But I know just what Bill is saying, and I know I've had so many people tell me the same thing, and they get 50 feet off and yell back, no taxes. And I appreciate that, and I appreciate it from the people it's coming for. But as I looked at it, and as I've said many times to that same person when I speak to him, the way I feel, if I can get down anywhere near the 3.7%, which is the cost of living for last year, and everybody on their Social Security got that increase, and everybody on government pensions got it, and every Army, Navy, Air Corps, and all the rest of them got it, well, I can live with that. That's the way I feel. So I'm working for 3 to 3.7. Bill's working for 0. I'd settle for 1.5.
Just one point, if we did get up to the, what was it, 160, what did you say?
Well, if you do it that way, we're at 163.
Yeah, and if we need to reinstate the 30,000 for the other.
The 133.
That would bring it down to 133.
Yeah.
To get to the 3.7, you needed 150.
149, yes.
Yeah, and you haven't looked at community services at all.
No, we got $16,000 we'd have to do if you had to put the $30,000 back in for the police. If you're going to go any lower than that, well, you've got to start cutting again.
I'd enjoy the percentage increase under 5, given what we did to the budget last year. I could live with a 5% increase.
I'm sorry, I can't.
I can.
Again, not in the context of this economy, but in the context of the what we did last year.
Any other comments on percentage of tax increase? Of the three figures put out, I'm hearing 0, 3.7, and 5. I would be happier between 3.7 and 5 because of all the ramifications on especially the municipal budget and the way it's been dealt with. You know, it comes down to some historical perspective also, how the municipal budget has been dealt with. And I'm not sure if we're going to, if we need to come to a conclusion on that.
I think you've got to get the school thing in first, don't you? The final makes quite a difference as to what we're doing here. If they come in at only a half of 1% instead of 4%, that would be quite a change in our thinking.
Mm-hmm. Well, we should know that Thursday night.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we can put something on hold, but I'm... But if they don't come through, I mean, you know, we're looking at another 100,000. It's not there. I mean, it's just not there. Yeah, it's unrealistic.
There's no reason they shouldn't come through on, you know, listening to the individual school board members, mm-hmm. there's no reason they shouldn't come through on that three-year financing. And out of the ones who spoke, there seem to be a majority who spoke for it.
I think
there are out savings there. And, you know, depending on what happens in the rest of today and tomorrow.
Yeah.
Or today.
Yeah,
I think there was a majority of school board members who were going to accomplish that financing situation. If we do get to a point where we need to cut another significant amount, we're going to have to do some policy rethinking. That's why I was hammering away at policies today. It will be major policy rethinkings in some cases, and that's why we have the discussion of public issues in public, so they will know our rethinking on policy issues if we get to that point. Okay. We do have a meeting with the school department on Thursday evening and also with community services for those, hopefully to finalize, hear the finalization of the school budget. It will be our first set down with the community services. Maybe we can get to finalize that also. We are going to need to meet again for the town budget. I don't know that we need to set that meeting tonight, today, though.
We may try to do it. You want to try to do it at the end of the council meeting, whenever it is?
The 13th?
The 13th.
What kind of agenda do we have that night?
Well, didn't look that big. The one major issue that I can think that's sitting there is the whether or not you want to authorize the school department to send in an application to the state. You know, beyond that, can you think of anything, Deb, that's... You tabled the sexual harassment policy, but that was on a technical issue.
Mm-hmm.
That shouldn't take long. We can keep the agenda short.
Yeah, I think that's...
There's nothing coming out of the ordinance committee, is it?
No, the 13th.
Yeah.
You will not be at that meeting, Phyllis?
I will not be at that meeting.
I prefer it at a time when all councilors can be present. If we can do that.
Well, we need to also schedule a budget meeting for the museum at Portland Head High,
right.
Too.
That's right.
We ought to combine those two.
Mm-hmm.
Why don't we see what happens Thursday night?
That's my inclination.
And then Thursday night make the decision about when we'll meet next.
And we'll try to schedule another budget meeting to look at the municipal budget revisits and to look at the museum budget.
Do you want me to communicate to them what you've done on fuel?
Them, the school?
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Definitely.
I'll make sure that what the board meets the 31st.
Yes.
School board, so I'll make sure that if I get up to Connie.
Great.
Monday.
If they could see at least a $5,000. That will help them too. We'll probably see. Yeah. Anything else we need to touch base on this afternoon?
And it's something that's not related to the budget.
I think we budgeted ourselves.
I think we're budgeted. It's for the council to consider a second town council meeting in May to be able to try to set some sort of date.
Rather than, do you want to turn the cameras off rather than debate when people
are you mean going through all our calendars?
If we're, yeah. if we're dealing with calendars, the public does not have to hear that.
Yeah.
I turn the cameras on and let those people go home.
Yes, that's what we're proposing to do.
Yeah.
It's 4 o'clock. I think we've got through
we made
fairly
it for,
well.
We made it time
Great.
Rather well.
Good
thank you all.
Good.
Especially thank the camera operators and Lillian for their time with us
this afternoon. Are you going to do it?
All questions submitted become the property of Texaco.